Hi there, my name is Pastor Greg, and you're watching Transforming the World. We are in the study of attentiveness in this topic of the Christian characteristics, or the characteristics that should be found in a Christian's life, working through something called the Disciples' Journal. And this week, we are looking at the attribute of attentiveness and how that plays into our life as a Christian, why it needs to be a part of our life as a Christian. Even the world's definition of attentiveness is something that we should all desire, to actually take the time to notice other people, to be considerate of other people, or even consider another person's feelings, or being attentive to another person's needs or their situation in life. That should be the mark of a Christian, that your eyes are on those around you, not just on yourself. Questions 1 through 4 in the self-evaluation section of the Disciples' Journal kind of teaches us, if you have the questions there in front of you, they kind of answer themselves, like, how do we develop this trait in our lives? And the questions kind of answer themselves. For example, number 1 is, we demonstrate that we are listening through body language, through eye contact, leaning forward, having an open stance, that kind of stuff. 2, we focus on the person speaking, not on those around us. The questions actually give away the answers on how we can develop this trait in our life. Number 3 is that we stop reading emails or texting while somebody else is talking to us. That's giving a person their full attention. If you've ever had a conversation with me, perhaps you have seen where I struggle with question number 4. Do I always look at the person who is speaking to me, or do I glance away to other people or other distractions? And I really struggle with that. Has a lot to do with my temperament. Because of my temperament, I struggle to really stay focused in the midst of a conversation. They never diagnosed it as ADD, but I've battled ADD for most of my life. I think I've gotten better at it, but over the years. But there are days I can let my guard down, and I'll be in the midst of a conversation. It may have been with you, and something distracts me, or somebody walks by, and I'm so easily distracted. I recognize that flaw in my life, that weakness in my life, and I am working. I really am. I am striving to get over this. There are times I've become distracted in the midst of a conversation because I'm having a conversation in my mind that says, don't get distracted. And it distracts me, if you know what I mean. Now, my point is this. When you recognize an area in your life where you are weak, you need to keep your mind focused on overcoming that weakness. You give it your full attention. There's a particular characteristic in your life. You understand this is an area where you are weak, either in your relationship with God or relationship with others, in a lot of different ways. You say, look, I'm really struggling with this and I'm weak with this. So you give it your attention. The author of Hebrews writes this, and I like this. The author writes, we must listen carefully to the truth we have heard, or we may drift away from it. That's Hebrews 2:1. And the truth is, we all have areas in our life where we need to grow. We need to grow in our interactions with others. We need to grow in our spiritual lives. We need to grow in our interactions with God. We all have those areas in our life. And so the challenge here is, look, give it your full attention. When God reveals something to you, and that's part of the benefit of this study. In this study of looking at the characteristics that should be found in a Christian's life, you're liable to hit on one that really kind of hits home. And we're liable to hit a topic that you say to yourself, man, that really, really struggle with that. Well, okay, when God reveals that to you, you need to give it your attention. Don't just casually look the other way or disregard it, but to give it your full attention, because if you don't, as the author of Hebrews says, you may end up drifting away from what? Drifting away from personal relationships, yes, or drifting away from your relationship with God, or drifting away even from your Christian faith. Unless you give it your full attention, this is what may end up happening. So when you recognize, when the Holy Spirit reveals to you an area in your life where you are weak, don't neglect it. Give it your attention. Don't let down. Don't let your guard down. So tomorrow we're going to take a look at some scripture examples in scripture that actually should encourage us. Some things that God reveals about himself that can be an encouragement. So I hope you can join us tomorrow as we continue to take a look at the Christian attribute of attentiveness. Thanks for spending time with me today, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow.